on the Field of Dreams at the Giamatti Center in Bristol, Connecticut for the Boys of Summer.
Win or lose, it's how you play the game. With everything you got, no energy saved, no emotion held back.
That one is to left, they play shallow.
And that's what baseball is, a game. A kid's game that says summertime and the innocent time of life.
Ripped to right field, this one's deep, and it is gone.
That gives us moments to cherish and life lessons to follow forever.
Welcome you to ESPN's coverage of the Little League World Series on the road to Williamsport. Today, an elimination day in the Mid-Atlantic region as Berlin, Maryland faces off with Mamie Johnson Little League out of D.C. Six teams comprised of the Mid-Atlantic region with Mid-Island Little League out of Staten Island, New York, the only team in this region to win their first two games of the tournament. Hi, everyone. Alongside Dave Belisle, John Brickley with you. Glad to have you with us. Today is an elimination day, which means there's a different vibe, coach, for the players, for the coaches as well. How do you handle the emotions of a day like this?
Well, as a coach, you do not mention elimination game. You get them focused, you get them pumped, you get them competitive, get your hands in, and let's go at it.
One of the great storylines in this tournament, specifically in this region, has been the boys from Mamie Johnson Little League, the first predominantly African-American team to make it to the Mid-Atlantic region. This is a program, coach, that began in 2015. They've made their way through districts, through states, now making it to regions. They are true pioneers in this sport.
They sure are, and I got to meet the coach this morning. Morning, Coach Bonds, and he is smiling from ear to ear, enthusiastic, proud to be here. His team belongs here. They've been playing some great baseball, and they will continue that today.
The excitement level has been through the roof for the players and for the fans as well. This is a program that's just about 13 miles outside of the nation's capital, named after Mamie Johnson, the first female pitcher in the Negro League. So what can we expect from a matchup like this today?
Well, we're going to see a very competitive game. Both teams are excellent. They're fundamentally sound. They're well coached. You know, both proud to be here. And again, no mention of elimination, but in the back of their minds, they know that they have to play their best.
It's a matchup of great expectation for these two teams. Berlin, Maryland going up against Mamie Johnson out of D.C. We've got the first pitch coming your way next on ESPN+.
Smokeless tobacco and e-cigarettes are all strictly prohibited at the Giamatti complex. Our security personnel reserve the right to inspect any bag or cooler, especially those left unattended. Balls will leave the field, so stay alert and return retrieved balls to the black gate behind home plate. In no circumstance shall a ball be thrown back onto the field. Noise-making devices are not permitted. And finally, do not stand along the front rail of each grandstand. Thank you for your cooperation, and enjoy the game.
A look at the Giamatti Center here in Bristol, Connecticut, as we get set for this elimination game in the Mid-Atlantic region between Berlin, Maryland and Washington, D.C. A beautiful day on hand this morning. Temperatures, however, are going to reach the mid to upper 80s, potentially even into the 90s as well. And as we take a look at the division at a glance, six teams modified double elimination with ages ranging from 10 to 13 years old. Six-inning game with two-thirds the conventional field size with a minimum mandatory play rule in effect. A look at the starting pitcher for Mamie Johnson Little League, DeJuan Taylor, nicknamed the Man-Child. Love these nicknames all these players get coming in here to Bristol for the Mid-Atlantic Regional. As D.C., the home team in their home purple, Berlin, Maryland, the visiting team in the road white with the blue. And we are set for this elimination game. And you had mentioned the emotions of going into an elimination game. And I would say patience has to be the biggest key coming into this one.
Oh, no question about it. And again, as a coach, you're not mentioning that elimination game. But you just got to keep on mentioning, stay competitive and back each other up. And who better than to have on the mound than the Man-Child himself? That's who you want in an elimination game. And he needs to throw strikes today.
Cannon Cropper, the pitcher, leading it off as that one fouled away. Behind in the count, 0-2. Maryland coming off a loss against New Jersey. Maryland making their second appearance in this tournament. They were also here in 2013. 0-2 pitch by Taylor misses high.
You know, it's important here for Cropper to get on. Get his team going, especially in these games where you're facing elimination.
Cropper swung on and missed, and the strikeout to begin the game for DeJuan Taylor.
Good stop for Taylor. Elevates on a two-strike count. Does his job. Everybody in the field feeling good.
So that'll bring up Stephen Wade. Nice start for Taylor on the mound today. The last team from Maryland to win the Mid-Atlantic Regional and then advance to Williamsport was Hagerstown Federal Little League. That was back in 2008.
Taylor looks sharp. Needs to be today. Like the way he's slowing it down. Stephen Wade's had a great tournament along the way, possesses great power, talking to the coach earlier.
Taylor misses high and he falls behind in the count 3-1.
Because they're going to need Wade, Kinnear, and Navarro to produce today.
In there for a called strike. If you talk to the coaches, one of their priorities in every practice is trying to get Wade to smile. Very serious individual.
Well, as long as he can keep his teammates smiling, that's the most important thing. Because he's a player.
Here's Taylor's 3-2 pitch upcoming. And drawing a one-out walk is Stephen Wade. Berlin, Maryland representing almost 5,000 people. That was incorporated back in 1868. I did not know this. Film location for Julia Roberts' film, The Runaway Bride.
How about that? One of my favorite actresses, Julia Roberts.
So with one out, that'll bring up the third hitter, Owen Kinnear, the shortstop.
I'm staying at the same hotel as these wonderful people, talking to many grandparents this morning, all excited about their grandchildren.
And Kinnear sends one to straightaway center. That there one is over the wall for a two-run shot. What a start for Berlin, Maryland, on the two-run home run from Owen Kinnear.
What a blast by Owen, getting a high fastball and delivering it over the left center field fence. Look at how happy that young boy is. Like I said, they're going to need Wade Kinnear and Navarro. And Mr. Kinnear delivers at the right time early in the game, giving his team confidence and blasting it out of here. There it was, up in the zone and delivers. Now we go back. Watch what happens at first base here. The coach says, get back and touch first base because, son, I think you missed it. And he went back, touched first. Let's make sure that we get the two runs, not the one run.
Yeah, we saw that the other day. Tommy Turner got a perfect game for Rhode Island.
Oh,
that one, nice catch
play
on the shortstop by Rocco Gilbert. And there are two away. Saw the Rhode Island coach question whether or not the Fairfield player in Coles rounded first, did not touch the bag, ended up turning out to be a perfect game for Tommy Turner.
That is correct. That is correct. Kinnear did the same there, but his own coach caught him that time. He came back, tagged, and he finished it. Nice play out there by Rocco Gilbert at shortstop.
Lucas Loring now steps to the plate. A 2-0 lead for Berlin, Maryland in this elimination game. Favorite team, the Atlanta Braves.
Playing some good ball. Nice job by Taylor to come back. Gave up the two-run bomb. Looked good before. Now, son, let's look good after. You got six innings to play here.
That one fouled away, falling behind in the count 1-2 with Loring.
He put a healthy cut on that. I think we're seeing this Maryland team now in their comfort zone. They've been here a couple of days. They want to bring their best today, and they have so far.
That one fouled away. It's been an interesting journey this year for Loring. Had a frustrating summer. Injured his throwing arm about 2 weeks prior to the start of district play. Was able to get through into states, and now has been a factor in the regionals as well for Berlin.
Oh, yes, I got the whole lowdown this morning from the grandparents. I had breakfast with them. So this is quite a young man. They're very proud of him. And yes, he had that arm problem, but still can deliver.
Just like he did there, ground ball right up the middle for a two-out base hit. And another runner aboard for Berlin, Maryland.
Nice piece of hitting right up the middle.
So during this breakfast,
yes,
it's a meet and greet where you had to provide not only an autograph but breakfast as well. How did that work out? Because I didn't get the invite, by the way.
Well, you know what? I'm attracted to them because they.
Here's Ryder Swanson, lofting one to short.
And nice
Rocco
catch again.
Gilbert comes up with the play that ends the inning. Owen Kinnear, though, putting Maryland on the board, a two-run home run. Our first chance to see Washington, D.C. midway through. Kinnear already with three home runs in this tournament, leading the regional.
Hey, Louis Bass, Cannon, and Kool-Aid are coming up. Great season in a row. Head to the Cannon booth to print your all-star photos and share them on the Great Wall of Fandom. You can also design a cheer sign and grab a baseball scorecard to make this the best season yet. Courtesy of Canon Pixma Printers.
2-0 Maryland meeting up with D.C. It's been a great story for this D.C. program. Adam Jones, the Orioles outfielder, saw a tweet by a Washington reporter in terms of helping out for the bus transportation for these boys, and it's been an amazing relationship between both sides.
I seen a tweet, and I reacted to it because everyone deserves an opportunity. When I look at a group of kids, I always envision myself being one of them. I think that they've deserved a chance to further their season. Those kids worked their tails off. They played hard, they fought, they won their league. I was able to FaceTime them. They had so much energy. They were so thankful and appreciative for myself's donation and other people's donations. And just the simple fact that they have somebody that believes in them, that right there is the most dearest thing that can happen.
Adam Jones, who contributed over $8,000 towards that bus transportation for the boys of Mamie Johnson Little League to come here to Bristol, Connecticut. D.C., just 13 miles outside for Mamie Little Johnson. And this is the first predominantly African-American team to win the D.C. title. Mamie Johnson, the first female pitcher to play in the Negro Leagues. It's been a fascinating story and a great relationship that, in fact, Keith Barnes, the manager for D.C., Coach Belisle has said that they're trying to plan a trip for the kids to meet in person with Adam Jones.
That's fantastic, and great job by Adam Jones. A true athlete, but a proud athlete, but he didn't do it for any notoriety. He's a giver. You know, he cares. He's played the game at a young level. He knows how difficult it is, and he reached out to those boys and made an opportunity to them to be here, and they're appreciative. He's appreciative of what they're doing. You heard him on the field. They're working hard. He gets it. They get it. And it's just a great story.
Jabril Scott with the chopper. Back to Cropper. Across the diamond. Not in time. Off the bag was the first baseman, Navarro, and the leadoff hitter on board for Scott.
Scott, blazing speed. Blazing speed. Going down that line. Watch this young boy get out of that box. Out of that box as quick as he can. I mean, that's just a bang-bang play, but it's all generated by the fact that this young boy was doing it and hustling down that line. He's pumped. Way to get your team going, son. That's huge to get that first guy on. It's because of you.
So Tony Hairston on board now, the catcher, first pitch swinging. Going back to Jones for just a second,
yeah.
One thing he implored after making the donation is that he wanted to see the next generation of players succeed. More importantly, he wants to integrate more African-Americans into the sport of baseball. If you go by the numbers, Dave, less than 8% of African-Americans play in the majors. That was from last year's numbers. Mm-hmm. And I really do commend Adam Jones for being that type of pioneer.
Well, Adam Jones is not a quitter. I can tell you that much. He didn't get to where he is today and the proud person that he is today by quitting. And he's going to be a giver. He's going to be a leader. And they're going to do something. You know, we need to recognize that. We need to get more young kids involved in baseball. And Adam Jones is reaching out and making people aware, and Little League Baseball aware, and the community aware that it's important to keep these young boys active. And why not Little League Baseball? It teaches us so much, and he knows that. That's why he wants to give, and that's why he's reaching out. Good job, Adam.
Hairston joins up with Scott on the base pass after drawing the walk. So two on to begin this game for D.C. against Cannon Cropper. And DeJuan Taylor, the starting pitcher for D.C., with his first plate appearance. D.C. ran into a buzzsaw, Dave. We called their game in the opening round of this Mid-Atlantic tournament, facing off with Staten Island, New York, in a game where we saw Steven Martinez go 3-for-3 with a home run. Mm-hmm. A very tough out in this tournament.
But you can tell both teams have blacked that out, come to the field to play baseball, both at sharp early. And we are going to see a very, very competitive game. Very competitive game. It's a great start for D.C. They've got to take advantage of this. They got the number three hitter up and good position here, first and second. He did great on the mound. What would be better than get himself a hit? Let's listen.
The first one, your front foot was way
for a second. Okay, just relax and throw. Let's just find a rhythm, okay? Don't try to do too much here. We don't need a strikeout. We want a ground ball, okay? So just get us a ground ball. That's all we need. Just find a good rhythm, okay, and let's just pound the zone. Let's make sure we're getting square behind the plate, okay? Let's go. Okay?
Can't Cameron McDonough with a quick visit to his starter, Cannon Cropper, in this first inning. What do you make of a mound visit this early?
I think it's important. I really, really do. He knows his boy is a good pitcher. He's a little tight, and let's loosen him up a little and let him know that it is early and we need you to throw strikes. Good job, coach.
2-0 pitch in there for a called strike by Cropper, who's a Manny Machado fan. Now, I must say, I bet a lot of these kids are no longer Manny Machado fans based on the fact that he's in L.A. now.
No, I doubt it. They still are. They'll always stay in touch. Always stay in touch. You get that one athlete that makes you tick, and you know what? I think they're going to stick with it. Stick with it. Manny's a good player, and that's what they look at. They look at the player. You know, they're not like us. They don't get into the contracts and the why didn't they stay, or they just love their athletes. And I think that's the pureness of Little League Baseball. Follow him because he's the athlete that you like to emulate.
Well, Cropper in a jam right now. 3-2 pitch. That one gets away. And another walk surrendered by Cropper back-to-back. And now the bases are loaded with the cleanup hitter, Kenyatta Carmichael Jr., coming to the plate.
John, in this tournament, we've seen the teams that have struggled because, the pitching has been, the bases on balls. So he needs to relax. He looked like he did on those first couple pitches. You know, it's okay, son. You got fielders behind you. At some point, he's going to get it again, and he's going to be fine, but he has to find it here. So a little delay as we get someone out warming up very early in the game. Elimination game, you got to get your boys up.
Foster Smith warming up for Berlin, Maryland. Even though with a 2-0 lead in a jam right now, nobody out with the bases loaded. Perfect start if you're DC. That one gets away, no advancement by the runners.
And he's overthrowing now. He's overthrowing, but come on, son, you can do it. You've been there before. But a good move by the coach. You got to get somebody warmed up right now.
Again, misses with his location, falls behind in the count, 2-0. You add in the pressure, Dave, of not only being on national television in a tournament game, but now add to that an elimination game.
Just missed. At this point, the boys in the field have got to do a little chitter-chatter for him. He needs to hear their voices. He needs to hear their voices.
That pitch misses low, and three straight walks allowed by Cropper brings home the first run for D.C. And so far, 17 pitches thrown in this first inning by Cropper. 13 of them have been balls. And now a second mound visit coming up by Coach McDonough.
Hey, listen. I know. But we're gonna let Foster come in now, okay? I need you to be right for Thursday, okay? I'm gonna give you another shot on Thursday. All right, just relax, okay? It's no big deal. Let's cheer on Foster. He's gonna come in here, he's gonna throw some strikes. We're just gonna get through this, and then Thursday's your day, okay? All right? Yeah, yep. Okay, good job, buddy. Come on, Foster.
So a change, Cannon Cropper out after 17 pitches as Foster Smith, we saw moments ago, warming up in the pen. He will be the new pitcher for Berlin, Maryland, up 2-1 in the bottom of the first, but no outs with the bases loaded. Meanwhile, we've seen so far, Coach, a lot of great stars shine on the diamond through the first couple of days of this tournament as well, starting with Steven Martinez leading Staten Island, New York, 4-for-6 with a home run. We saw a perfect game in the form of Tommy Turner. And let's not forget the home run we just saw in the first inning by Owen Kinnear with three home runs leading this regional tournament.
It's a great play like we always do in this tournament. It's nice to associate yourself with those top-notch players and the ability to perform at such a high level. Martinez, Turner, Blake, Kinnear. Wonderful tournament so far, and I expect them to continue it. They're just players. They're dynamite. And somebody else will step up, too. They're not the only players in this tournament, but they are the leaders of this tournament. But watch. We're going to find some other names up there. They're going to make big plays at the right time and get their kids, their fellow kids, into a victory column.
What do you make of the decision by Maryland to quickly go with a pitching change?
It's the right decision. There's no question it's the right decision. He had no location, and you know what? I think the boy in the mound wanted to get out of there, too. That's my honest feeling. I just think that he just didn't have it. He was nervous. He's got some horses out there. You got to come in and have somebody that's at least going to throw strikes. And it's not that the boy couldn't, you know, he's not a strike thrower. He is. He was just nervous. And we all, these kids get to that point where sometimes you just, it's not your day.
But
he's going to have a chance at the plate. He's going to have a chance to redeem himself. I think he's going to be okay in this game, and he's glad he's not on the mound. That's basically what it is. Give it to somebody else. That's what I talked about at the beginning. We got to pick each other up.
Sol McKinney, first hit. That one's a fair ball. One run's going to score. Another one's going to come in for DC that gives them the lead on a first pitch swinging McKinney two-run double, and it's a 3-2 lead for DC.
Great job by McKinney, okay? Knowing that he's going to be coming in throwing strikes, he jumps on that first pitch and sails one down the line, right down the line, and that's a fastball. And get himself a couple RBIs out there. Great job by McKinney.
And still no one out with Rocco Gilbert, the shortstop, the number six hitter in this lineup for DC. So Hairston and Taylor both score. Carmichael goes to third. And McKinney on to second. And potentially, Coach McDonough would like to challenge this call to see whether or not that ball was fair.
What are you challenging, Coach, exactly?
Well, from my vantage point, that was definitely a fair ball. But a good challenge, you know. You got to try to stop momentum somehow. You got two there waiting for you.
So it will be a video review that was instituted back in 2008. Coaches have unlimited challenges through the 4-6 innings, one in the extras.
What's McKinney turn on this baseball here? I mean, sail it right down the line. Close, but I thought it went right over the bag. See that? Oh, it was close. But look, from the vantage point, right. Now he's right there. I mean, the umpire is right there. So I think the only one that's going to be able to determine if that's fair or foul, John, is that umpire, because the angle would have had to have come from behind, and that's an angle that's coming from in front. The ball lands before the bag. Look at the umpire. Great position. He's the one who's going to make that determination. I think it's a great challenge, but that is going to be a very difficult play to overrule because of the positioning of the umpire. Great position.
The call on the field is a fair ball.
But a good challenge, because that was close.
Steven Schwartz is our home plate umpire, taking a look at this challenge by Maryland. We'll get the official ruling.
It is a big play in the game. It's early, though, and the way both these teams have come out swinging, it won't be the last runs that have scored, but it's a big play.
Apparently, Schwartz needs to take some further look at the replay of this one. Again, it's a fair ball on the field with the Maryland team challenging it. If it does hold up, it still would be a 3-2 lead for DC. As McKinney was aggressive right from the start. First
yes.
pitch swinging against the new pitcher, Foster Smith, as we get the official ruling.
Good call.
So the call confirmed, a two-run double for Solomon McKinney. And DC has their first lead in this tournament, 3-2.
Good response by DC.
As Rocco Gilbert steps in. Check swing.
Yes, he did.
And he went around.
And Foster Smith doing a good job. Throw strikes, son. And that's what he's doing. No more freebies. Let's play ball.
Smith. To short across the diamond. Nice play by Kinnair. That'll bring home another run. And it's a 4-2 lead for DC.
But a good decision. Surround the ball, make a nice play, get outs right now. Let's get out of this inning, get some outs, and get our bats going again. Nice play.
Is number five, the second baseman, Steven Showalter.
Steven Showalter, the number seven hitter. Favorite athlete, Max Scherzer. Foster Smith coming in relief. All four pitches have been strikes so far.
Keep the pressure on. Oh, nice curve right there. Beauty. Not easy to come in a bases-loaded situation. You've been on the bench. You weren't in the field. Get out. Get two warm-ups to come into this situation. Doing a great job.
And the slow roller to first. And out at first. A nice bang-bang play there. As Showalter unable to avoid the tag by Navarro. One more run scores for DC. Make it 5-2.
Navarro, nice play. Good hustle again. Showalter busting it down the line. Get the outs, boys. You're doing the job by getting the outs. But again, put the bat on the ball. He drives in a run. Does his job. Extends it to 5-2. A nice play out there. But I'm missing Navarro. Good job, son.
Ian Makel, the number 8 hitter. First pitch swinging.
They're coming out swinging.
That one set in the shallow left center field for a base hit. Makel wants it more on, and so now it's 3 hits in the first inning for DC.
Even a nice job of hitting. Off speed, stayed with it, extended his arms, and lofted it right over the shortstop.
By the way, Dave, I know you're a Yankee fan. Yes. Does Foster Smith remind you of Joe Kelly?
Yes.
Right?
Yes, he does. Absolutely.
Doesn't he look like a young Joe Kelly?
Yeah, he does. He looks like a young Joe Kelly. Also looks like Tyler Clippett a little. I don't
Tyler Clippett, there you go. That was the other one I was thinking of.
All
yeah.
All I know is he's a good pitcher. He's got good form. He's doing a good job. He's getting the outs and throwing strikes. This is what they needed right here. I know a couple runs have come in when he's been on board, but he's gotten the outs. It's a great job right there. Great job. Continue doing that.
Jaden Brown, the number 9 hitter. 9 of the 10 pitches thrown by Foster Smith have been strikes. Again, this is an elimination game. One of these two teams will continue on the road to Williamsport. The other will, unfortunately, see their season come to an end. Brown cut on and missed, and it's 2-2.
And how about DC coming out and turning, almost turning the order here. They're one player away from turning it to the top of the order in the first inning. Can't get better than that.
Brown taking. And Smith comes up with a strikeout that ends the inning. But DC putting 5 runs across on 3 hits. They've got a 5-2 lead at the end of 1 here in Bristol.
Adult volunteers and generous financial support.
Thank you.
Right now, regional volunteers are coming through the crowd, accepting your donations. Your contributions help to defray the cost of running this regional tournament, including the expense of housing and feeding all teams at no cost to the players or their Little League programs. Thank you for your generous support of Little League Baseball.
I just didn't see anybody else doing it, so I...
As we begin the second inning here in Bristol, Connecticut, DC a 5-2 lead on Maryland. John Brickley, the coach Dave Belisle with me. And Coach, you've been on this journey a couple of times with Cumberland, Rhode Island, taking them to the Little League World Series in 2011 and 2014. It is a long journey, starts with districts, then in sections, moving on to states where we are now, step number four with the regionals. But the ultimate step is step number five, getting to the College World Series, the Little League World Series, I should say.
That's right. It's been a long summer, but it's been a great summer for all these kids who are here right now. They deserve to be here. They've had incredible games along the way, and now the competition stiffens up, and they're getting a taste of getting to Williamsport.
7, 8, 9 hitters for Maryland, starting with Adam Gardner, the second baseman. Favorite athlete, LeBron James, who's now a L.A. Laker.
Good takes right there. Let's get some base runners. Good takes. Make sure Taylor throws strikes.
Taylor, who gave up the two-run home run to Owen Kinnear in the first inning, comes back with a strike. Still good, behind in the count, 2-1.
Good comeback pitch, too. Nothing over the middle of the plate. Kept it to the outside corner. Dangerous hitter.
How important is it early? We saw both teams in that first inning put runs on the board, especially in an elimination game, to get some runs across, to get that confidence up.
At any level, but especially with kids, you know. They need some momentum. They need some excitement early, get the nerves away from them. And when you score runs, you get excited, you're enthusiastic, you're pumped. So it's both teams are on their game. Now Taylor needs to throw strikes and keep his team in with the lead, and he's doing that right now.
Full count, ground ball, and a leadoff single to begin this second inning for Adam Gardner in Berlin, Maryland. Coach, we were walking to the ballpark this morning, you after meeting up with the grandparents at the hotel, but it is hot today here in Bristol. Temperatures are gonna reach close to 90 degrees. The humidity already at 77%, feels like 95 degrees. So a big shout out to all the camera personnel out on the field today working hard for us in this blazing sun.
Yeah, and umpires and all you catchers out there, drink a lot of water. And it is a hot day, but it's summer. And this is what you get to come to expect.
Great camera guys,
nice
all the way
play
around. Taylor, nice job starting the double play potentially. However, able to beat out the throw is Waylon Hopgood. And so with one out, still a runner on for Berlin, Maryland.
Taylor makes a nice play right here.
Now batting the right fielder, number two.
Watch him set himself, look to the bag, find who's covering. Throw it to the bag right there. It might have been a little confusion, but Taylor does a good job, doesn't hesitate, throws it to the bag. Showalter takes it and makes a nice release to turn. But good hustle down the line to eliminate that double play. Just good baseball right there by Taylor. Get the out, get the lead man.
Gavin Salido, the number 9 hitter for Berlin, Maryland, fouls that at one away. How difficult is it to play in this type of heat?
Terrible. It's really tough to keep the kids, cool, because the kids, especially your substitutes who are sitting there, and the dugouts are hot. I know it's hot in the field, but the dugouts are hot.
Ball gets away from the catcher, Hairston. Advancing on to second is Hopgood on the wild pitch thrown by Taylor.
Even more important for the pitchers to throw strikes, John, because, nothing worse than standing out in that outfield and ball after ball after ball, it gets hotter and hotter and hotter. That's when you think about heat.
I remember a few weeks ago I played golf when it was almost like felt like 110 degrees outside.
Oh, I don't feel for it, kid. You were playing golf.
In pants. I kept asking myself, what am I doing here?
I guess you were confused. You had pants on.
That one just misses on the outside to make it a full count to the number 9 hitter, Salido.
Doing a good job, working the count full. Let him bring it in. Good swing. Good job by Taylor, keep throwing the strikes. Let your players play. This is a good at-bat right here by Salido.
Yeah. Ground ball to short. Gilbert trying to make a play at third. Instead, both runners are safe. And Berlin, Maryland threatening with runners at the corners.
Nothing Gilbert could do there except eat the ball and chase the runner down because he would never would have had him at first base. A good pitch by Taylor. Nice pitch. Good job by Salido. Put the ball in play. Put pressure on the defense. Hands are in. Hustling down that line. But watch, Gilbert makes a nice play. Gets in the hole. But look, he makes the right decision right there. If he tries to throw that, you know, something could have thrown the ball wild, but he took his time.
On the wild pitch by Taylor. As Salido moves to second, makes it second and third with one out. Foster Smith, the batter, came in for Cannon Cropper.
Well, let's listen in. Good visit right here.
So DC with a 5-2 lead. Quick mound visit here with Berlin, Maryland threatening with just one out and two on. DC, who really broke through what has been a stranglehold in the nation's capital by Capital City Little League, Northwest Washington Little League. They've represented DC in every regional since 98. So really they are the new kids on the block in more way than one for DC.
Deservedly so. I've been impressed. A good squad.
Draws down the bunt to Smith.
Keeping the pressure on the defense. You get a bunt down, you get a run, and you never know, a base hit too. The infielders on both the third base and first base, now they're coming in, expecting the bunt.
Outside, falling behind the count, Taylor 2-1. Maryland, as mentioned, fell to New Jersey, so they, along with DC, are one loss away from being eliminated in this Mid-Atlantic Regional Tournament. 2-1, Smith goes to second. Unable to handle it is Showalter. That allows a run to cross in the form of Hopgood, and it's a 5-3 lead now for Washington, DC.
Again, we've seen many of these balls come up on these young infielders. Showalter does a nice job. He's done everything correctly right here. You know, he's on his toes. He surrounds the ball. It comes up. Bad hop. Keeps it in front of him. No luck.
So now a pinch runner coming in. Cannon Cropper, who began this game on the mound, was replaced by Foster Smith.
Nice job by Foster Smith right there. Put the ball in play. Had a man on third base with less than two outs. Gets himself an RBI. No, it's not special pitch
runner. So Cropper is on first after Smith was able to reach on an error by the second baseman Showalter. Salido is on third now. And that will bring up Stephen Wade, who drew a walk his first time up. 5-3, DC with the lead on Berlin, Maryland, who is threatening in this second.
Nice pitch. That's where he has to keep it. Stephen is such a good hitter. You do not want this young boy extending those arms. And Taylor painted black there with an off speed. See what he does here.
He and Kennard tied for the tallest player in the Mid-Atlantic. That one laced, but just foul. Both are standing 5'10". I'm 5'10", I'm 34 years old, coach.
And shrinking.
Well, you don't hold that back on your criticism, do you?
I know.
I called you Silver Fox one time, you won't hold it against me anymore.
Hey, I can't shrink anymore.
Can't shrink anymore.
All right, good battle right here. Big moment in the game, too. Taylor first and third. See what kind of pitch you're going to bring, son.
Outside.
And a good pitch. Make him chase.
Great job. two to Wade, taking all the way to even up the count at 2-2.
Good effort by Taylor right there. Good effort. Just missed. Keep it coming, son. It was a good pitch.
This one skied into center field. Scott has a play on it. Tagging up from third is Salido, and he will score without a problem. Trying to advance to second on the slide is Cropper, so the sacrifice fly gets Berlin Maryland within a run.
Nice job by Wade to get the run home. As he lofts one off the center field.
Coming to the plate,
Scott makes a good throw home.
Number 00, Owen Kinnair.
Owen Kinnair now steps to the dish. All he did in his first plate appearance was connect on a two-run home run in the first inning to put Maryland in front. His third home run of this regional tournament. And an intentional walk issued, and maybe a smart play by DC.
Yep, good, smart play. Hey, previous to that, John, that hit and the catch, I mean, a nice play. He stepped up the line on that ball, and the sacrifice fly, cut the ball through a strike to second base. It was a bang-bang play. The ball got loose, but I like the presence of mind by Hairston, the catcher. Left-handed catcher. Love it.
Alex Navarro, who lined out to the shortstop Gilbert his first time up, takes a first-pitch strike. I've asked you this question before,
yep.
Coach, but what's your philosophy on how aggressive you should be with a new pitcher?
Hey, we need runs and we can hit. I say hit it.
And Navarro hits it right to the shortstop Gilbert across the diamond for the putout. But Maryland coming up with two more runs. They only trail 5-4 to DC midway through the second.
Coming to Bristol and visiting the All Heart City. Log on to bristolallheart.com to find out about our hidden gems, attractions, and places to eat while here for the tournament. It's the place to go when you need to know where to go. bristolallheart.com.
Child.
Love these,
Taylor.
Love these names. Cash Money. I want to hang with that guy right there. Especially when he gets into high school. Holy Moses. And the man child.
I
do not want to mess with the man child.
I still love Reed Tully, Ginger Sauce, and Noah Wells, Clutch Master 2. So Scott, who led off this game with a single.
But, you know, I don't know if I want to get a little old into a board meeting and they're calling me Ginger Sauce.
Ginger Sauce.
I like it, but they got to let it go. I like it, though. What names?
Oh, I have a nickname for you. Scott with the ground ball.
Speed,
down
speed.
By the second baseman. And, again, nice job by Scott with that speed to be able to beat out the throw.
Again, two times in a row. Puts the bat on the ball. Infielders are making good plays. God, that makes a great play in this ball. This is smoked, dives, knocks it down, picks it up. He looks at the base, and Scott's already by the bag. I mean, that's just speed. Nothing you can do about that, son. Good stop, good baseball, good hustle.
Brings Tony Hairston to the dish. Meanwhile, I want to make our viewers aware of the Little League International Urban Initiative that was established in 1999. Over 220 leagues across the U.S. as Hairston, ground ball to Gardner, turns for one, gets the force out at second.
Well done.
Really across the United States, the Little League Urban Initiative currently operates within 220 leagues in nearly 90 cities, and this has been just a remarkable story surrounding these young men who are coming from D.C., Mamie Johnson Little League, as mentioned, the first team that has been predominantly African-American to advance to the Mid-Atlantic Regional. Saw their story earlier on SportsCenter. It's been just a remarkable journey for these young boys to be able to make it all the way here to Bristol.
And they want that journey to continue. They're showing it today. They're playing good baseball, excellent baseball. Both sides, keep it going.
One-oh pitch, Taylor, right back towards us. So, are you interested in hearing what the nickname I came up for you?
For me?
Yeah, I thought about it long and hard.
You did?
I did.
All right, was it in the golf game when you had the long pants on?
No. Just came to me, actually.
What is it?
I think you're gonna like it.
What is it?
Old Yellow. Come on.
I think, you know what? If my kids were here, I think they would agree with you. I am an old yellow.
See,
I yelled so much when I was a coach. I had no voice left, but old yellow.
Old
yellow. My God. That's pretty good, John.
That's it.
Pretty good.
I took some time. I wrote some down.
That's good.
You know, scratched them.
Just don't tell that to Ravitch when he comes in, please.
No, believe me. When I'm in studio for your games later this week, believe me, I will. 2-1 pitch now to Taylor.
Taylor can help himself here with a base hit. I was going to go earlier, though, when I saw Hairston up, he had faked the bunt, you know? He was bunting. Now, when you're a coach, once you see the bunt, you want your guys coming in. But Hairston's a huge, strong hitter. You see the kid bunting, and you're saying to yourself, please, Lord, do not change your mind and swing.
Taylor can't catch up with the high heat from Foster. I always joked it was like when Big Poppy tried to lay down a bunt.
Oh, God.
Which I'm surprised some of these guys don't drop down the bunt with a shift on.
No, I'd rather have three than a bunt. That's what Poppy could do. He can produce three. You got a couple guys on. Nice pitch, right out of eight.
Unable to check his swing. Smith with the strikeout. Now they're two away.
Smith doing a good job right here. Keeping throwing strikes, keeping his infielders involved. And then at the right moment, throwing a high heat to Taylor, who's a very good hitter. Good job, son. Very, very good job. One more to go, though. Carmichael has something to say.
The cleanup hitter who drew a walk his first time up. Here with two outs, and Hairston on at second.
Be important right here to get a run, get another run. Go back and forth, but you'd like to come out of this inning with a run.
That one in there for a called strike, and Foster Smith is one strike away from getting out of this inning. They appealed down to first, did not go.
Good hold, good pitch. I like the mixing that he's doing right now. He's doing a great job. Keep it up.
One, two, and Carmichael with a solid swing that goes foul.
Good piece of hitting right there. Foul off a tough pitch. Hopefully it makes a mistake and you get yours. You can produce. Good hitter, Carmichael, good hitter.
Trying to go inside, trying to steal from second is Hairston. Easy play by the catcher, Ryder Swanson, and that ends the inning. Nice job by Swanson to get the runner out at third. 5-4 DC at the end of two.
Safe house. Okay.
Hello. Hold on. Tell me when you're ready. He's challenging self-same out.
Second game's not going to start till like 6 o'clock.
As we return to Bristol, right before the inning ended, Keith Barnes wanted to challenge the play. Here's how Tony Hairston was sliding into third. Originally, Ryder Swanson, we thought, had the throw that beat Hairston. As we take some other vantage points here, Dave, it appears that Hairston was able to beat the throw.
Well, I don't know about beating the throw, but avoid the tag is what this is right here. And I think he did. I think the glove did not go to the towards the feet and went to the knee area. And, you know, it's tough to tell, but from my vantage point right there, it looks like he touches the knee, but the feet are on the bag. It's going to be a close call. Again, you're trying to overcall something that's been ruled out. But it looks like he may have gotten in there. But anyways, a good challenge.
Carmichael is the cleanup hitter. Hairston is your number two hitter. As we get another angle of the slide and the tag that was applied by Stephen Wade.
I think right there, I guess the coach was thinking of surprise because it's very difficult to steal, as we've seen, John, and these tournaments, because the catches are so good and strong and it throws a precision. Difficult to steal, but they may get a break here. But your cleanup hitter's up. Maybe you'll get another chance to drive in a run.
Well, offense has been certainly the theme so far this game. Maryland started off with an Owen Kinnaird two-run home run, his third in this tournament. DC then followed up with five in the bottom of the first inning. In the second, Maryland was able to cut the deficit down to one with a pair of runs and looking to continue to have this bottom of the second keep going.
The longer the wait, the hotter it gets.
As both managers, with Coach McDonough, Coach Barnes, having a good laugh waiting through this review.
Great to see. Everyone gets along. They compete on, in between the lines, but there's a certain level of competition here at the Little League level. There's total respect. Talk about young children playing a great game. We need the coaches to be leaders. That's what they are. They want to show the kids that it's a friendly competition. We want to win.
In the end, you want to get the call right. That's the bottom line.
Oh, God. Here we go. And they got it right.
So Hairston will come up with the steal that continues to extend this bottom of the second inning. So all the players for Berlin, Maryland have to go back to their position on the field, and so we will resume the bottom half of the second with two outs. 2-2 count. Carmichael's going to be back at the plate with Hairston now at third.
And now with a guy at third, we have a chance, a couple chances. One, drive in a run, and also pass ball, a wild pitch might give an opportunity for another run. So good situation here. But DC, see if they can take advantage of a break. They got the right guy to do it too. Number four guy. That's what he's there for, producing. He's pumped. He gets a chance to drive in a run.
Foster Smith's 2-2 pitch. Carmichael lines one but foul. And Hairston made just a beeline to home plate.
No blocking that plate.
Great hustle by Hairston. I love the shades too.
They're beautiful. I do. I really
I think
like
those are some stylish shades.
Match the unis.
That one misses, and so Carmichael's been able to work the count now in his favor. 3-2 with two outs.
And Smith still mixing it up, doing a good job.
Here's the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Carmichael with the dribbler to third. Wade with the play across the diamond for the out. And so Harrison Steele neglected. And so it's a 5-4 lead for DC at the end of two. You're watching ESPN's coverage of the Little League World Series on the road to Williamsport. 5-4 DC on top of Maryland. We move to the third inning here in beautiful Bristol, Connecticut. This game, one of two elimination games on this Tuesday. Pennsylvania and Delaware will be the other. So the winner of both those games continues onto the road to Williamsport. Unfortunately, the one who falls to defeat in this game, their season comes to an end. So it's a little bit of a difficult position, Coach, to be in, to have your season on the line in one game.
But a position that at least they have the chance, and they're here and they're enjoying themselves. It is sad when it ends, but once they get back home, and there's only going to be a couple winners from this tournament, but when they get back home and they realize the accomplishments, the journey, the excitement they had, they can reminisce, and there'll be people waiting home from being so proud of them. It's an elimination game, but it's not elimination. Not eliminating the memories that they're going to create here.
So Lucas Loring, the center fielder, start things off for Berlin, Maryland. He sends one to high, straightaway left. That one off the wall, rounding first and in the second with a stand-up double to lead off the inning. Lucas Loring, what an at-bat.
This team coming in, get hit, and Lawrence one of them, and he gets all of this one. Just missing a home run as it hit the fence. Launches this right off the middle of the fence. Nice piece of hitting right there. You know, those bats again, John, that, you know, we had talked about it throughout the whole telecast, that have they changed the bats and how they've limited the power of them, more reminiscent of like a wooden bat, which is, I think, it makes the game a better game. But if this was last year, that ball would have ended up in the woods.
USA bat standard that was implemented the first of this year. Meanwhile, defensive changes. Joshua Young, the new left fielder for DC. Langston Speed at third. Daniel Marshall is at second. So a leadoff double by Loring has him in scoring position with a chance to tie this one up with Berlin, Maryland. Case Tillman pinch hitting now with a 2-0 count.
I think one thing Taylor has done, though, he has thrown strike after strike. He's not getting those walks. He's giving his team a chance. He's making the other team earn it, and they are earning it.
You have to appreciate the aggressiveness by both offenses here today, quickly getting runs on the board. Have to leave everything out on the field in this elimination game.
They are. They're bringing it. Both teams bringing it at the plate. They are aggressive and very confident.
As that one hits Tillman, so the first two runners get on for Berlin, Maryland here in this third inning. Adam Gardner, the second baseman, who had a base hit last inning at the plate with a chance with two on and no one out. Squares up to bunt.
Now we got Taylor up at 58 pitches. So when you get into these types of games where there's a lot of runs early, it's going to be the depth of the pitching staffs that's going to have to come through. Taylor's doing his job. It's just that he's facing an extremely good hitting team. But
gets away from the catcher, Hairston. Both runners advance. Now second and third with no one out. And we've made that a hot topic of conversation, managing a game within a game, not only the mandatory play, but now the pitch count as well. How does that change your philosophy in an elimination game?
Oh, you got to, you know, you got to kind of like black out tomorrow because it is an elimination game. I mean, you want to leave something just in case you do win, but you got to win this. You got to win this game. But Taylor's going to go the distance. That's for sure.
He's at 60 pitches now. In some trouble with two on. As Gardner goes opposite way, Showalter unable to hold on to it, and the tying run comes across here for Berlin, Maryland in this third inning. Loring scores to tie it up at five.
That was Daniel Marshall, I think. Again, you know, Danny makes a good play on the ball, but it just popped out of his glove. Again, this ball's hit very hard. Again, the ball comes up. We've seen it time and time again. But because of the short distances on these base pads and the speed that these young boys can create, it's very difficult to make a play unless it's you make a clean play. Don't worry about it, son.
Riley Callaway, pitch hitting.
It's one of the most difficult things, too, John, is, you know, you got to forget about that last one. You got to get the next one. You got to ask for the ball, and that's not easy.
Going to second, uncontested on the steal is Gardner, so it's second and third here for Berlin, Maryland, tied up at five. After the error by Showalter at second, allowed the tying run and Loring to score. So Callaway in pinch hitting, part of the mandatory play.
And today you're going to need your bench. You need everybody contributing today. There's no question about it.
And here comes Coach Barnes out of the dugout for D.C.
Okay. Hey, come here. You're going to go to third. You're going to outfield. You're going to second. Okay? Hey, man, good job. Way to throw. Okay? Look, man. Good job. Good job. You did good? Hey, man, pound the zone. Okay? Hey, come on, man. Energy, energy, energy. Come on.
Gotta go.
Glasses. Take your sleeve off. Yes, you gotta take it off. Thank you.
You don't need it anyhow. It's just extra weight.
So a pitching change with Carmichael coming in. In a 5-5 game, Maryland and DC. We're back in a moment.
Defensive changes for the District of Columbia. Now playing at third base is number 6, Daywan Taylor. On the mound is number 1, Kenyatta Carmichael Jr. At second base will be number 24,
Catch all the excitement of the Little League World Series, including how to visit Williamsport, score, stats, highlights, and more. Visit littleleague.org or follow along on social media with the hashtag LLWS. Number of changes defensively for D.C. Langston Speed, your new second baseman. Daniel Marshall is in right. Kenyatta Carmichael, is our new pitcher, with Deshaun Taylor now moving over to third base. Carmichael, whose nickname is KK, and give credit to DeJuan Taylor, did a great job in his start today, Dave.
He sure did, especially with this heat. He did. He gave his team a chance. He threw strikes. He kept them in the game. And I love the coach coming out and very proud of his young boy and keeping everybody relaxed. And keeping Taylor in the game, too. Just a good job, coach. I like him.
So Callaway heading the count 3-0 in a game that's tied up at 5, an elimination game. And that one ball 4 to load the bases. So Tillman is on third, Gardner is at second, now Callaway with the walk is at first. A look at Keith Barnes, the manager for Washington, D.C., who has done a tremendous job guiding this program since its inception in 2015, has had a hand in also being able to form the relationships between Adam Jones and his players, along with Howie Kendrick as well. The Nationals, ground ball to second, Speed with the play to first. That brings home the go-ahead run, however, in the form of Tillman. So a 6-5 lead now for Berlin, Maryland.
Nice job by Speed. Eight outs. It's going to be a long game. Rolling in the bottom of the third. Should be top of the third, but get the outs. Nice job. Just gets into the game. We've seen some trouble at second base with some bad hops. He stays down on it, makes a nice play, gets an out. Good job right there.
Back to the top of the lineup for Maryland, Foster Smith. First pitch swinging. So we have seen so far Maryland put up at least 2 runs in every inning this game. Smith, a Duke basketball fan.
You got the Duke colors on, too. Oh, nice pitch. Tom Michaels, throw your strikes to get the infield in right here. Want to cut down that run of the plate, but more importantly, if they don't think they have a chance, get another out.
Smith fouls it away. Falls behind the count 1-2.
Yes, you were mentioning your Coach Bond has done a wonderful job with these young boys. Making them feel good, making them feel competitive, giving them a chance, working hard, making the journey here, playing so well right now. And they still look loose. They look good. They're in a great ball game.
Smith taking all the way in there for a called strike. Coach McDonough not a fan of that call by the home plate umpire, but it's the second out.
Carmichael's keeping it away, but you know, I think we were all deceived by the catcher came up and Hairston. And the vantage points of the coach, you get a little confused when that catcher does stand up, but it looked like he might have caught the corner. Good pitch by Carmichael.
Stephen Wade, first pitch swing to the shortstop. Gilbert unable to handle it. One run will score, another will come in for Berlin, Maryland. They've tacked on a couple and now lead 8-5.
Wade stays hot. Stephen always hits the ball hot. Right here, he smokes this thing. Right through the shortstop hole. Now he's on the grass area, slips a little. Again, Rocco Gilbert makes a great effort, but too hard hit a ball.
An 8-5 lead as Owen Kennard steps to the dish. A home run so far in this game for him, 3 in this tournament.
And now we got a pitch to him. We got a man on first. You're already trailing by 3. Got a pitch to him. Just be careful.
Favorite player, Carlos Correa, on the DL for the Astros.
He is a presence, though, huh? Isn't he? Presence at that plate.
Hairston unable to hold on to the pitch. Advancement by the runner to second is Wade.
Now the base is empty. I wonder if they're going to put him on.
If you're from around Connecticut, you know the name George Springer from Britain.
That's right.
Was on the DL yesterday after a thumb injury that he suffered Sunday against the Dodgers.
What a great ball player he is. Big reason why. Superstar. Big World Series.
How about his leadoff power the other day? First pitch of the game at a home run. Here's a dribbler to second.
Nice job by Speed.
And that ends the inning. But four runs come across for Berlin, Maryland. They lead 8-5 midway through the third.
Fans, why not take home a cherished memento from the Little League East Region Tournament? Official souvenirs and gifts are available at the Little League Gift Shop located next to the pavilion. You'll find t-shirts, sweatshirts, caps, pins, and more. And while you are shopping, be sure to pick up. There's nothing better. Summer forever.
Summer forever.
The sights of Williamsport, August 16th through the 26th. We'll have coverage on ESPN, ESPN2, and on ABC. And there it is, Lomedy Stadium, where you have been twice before, my friend. Take Cumberland, Rhode Island in 2011 and 2014. An amazing atmosphere to be a part of. And we'll bring you the coverage. Already some tickets have been punched internationally. Asia Pacific will be represented by Seoul, South Korea, Barcelona, and Spain is also going to go. Puerto Rico will be representing the Caribbean. It's here, Dave. The road to Williamsport.
Best time of the year. No question about it. I was fortunate enough to go and experience it. But you saw that beautiful stadium, both of them, when they're empty. But it's even more beautiful when it's filled with fans who appreciate young kids play. And it's unbelievable.
One of these two teams hoping to keep that hope alive of getting to Williamsport, Maryland, and D.C. in an elimination game in this Mid-Atlantic Regional. Solomon McKinney, who came in with the two-run double, batting fifth in this lineup, favorite team, the Golden State Warriors. McKinney skies one to right field. That was a great play on the run. Gavin Salido comes up with a nice web jab.
What a play out there by Gavin. Fabulous. Even appreciation out there from the first base coach, Coach Barnes. This is a very difficult play. But he turns perfectly on the ball, goes back, and makes a nice grab. He had that all the way, and that was smoked out there. Beautiful play. Very difficult play. Very difficult. And in the sun. Just a great play.
Rocco Gilbert sends one to straightaway center field. And another great catch in the outfield. Lauren comes up with the nice catch. So back-to-back catches by this outfield core for Berlin, Maryland.
Defense, defense, defense. You know, watching D.C. doing everything they can, putting beautiful at-bats out here. I mean, two balls that are just smoked out there. Again, another great play. Good defense. And Smith doing his job, throwing strikes. Let the defense play, and they are.
Daniel Marshall hitting bottom of the third. They're not wasting any time here, Dave. Just going right to it.
But as a coach, you know what? You slap your boys high five for putting a good swing in the ball. There's nothing you can do.
Smith delivers. Marshall jammed up and trying to extend to try to make the catch, unable to. Salido nearly had a second web jam this inning.
Might have jammed his wrist a little there, but the effort. Who's the first one out there, too, is Coach Bonds. That's baseball. But look at this effort. I mean, he is digging, 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 diving. Oh, what a try out there.
Still in some pain. You could tell the awkward landing on the attempt by Salido.
Oh, my God. What an effort out there. This young boy can play. He can play outfield. Look at him. He's smirking, too.
He's got the shades going.
Yeah, he could have had two.
Looks the part.
Two ESPN web gems there. You know what? I think they should show the other one for the effort.
As the athletic trainer here on campus taking a look at that wrist that Salido jammed up. Also, Cameron McDonough, the manager for Maryland, on hand to take a look, making sure that Salido is okay after that great diving attempt.
I mean, here you got a great break on the ball, too. All out effort, all extension.
So here's what's at stake in this Mid-Atlantic Regional double elimination tournament. The winner will move on to play the winner of tonight's game against Delaware or Pennsylvania coming up on Thursday at 7 Eastern. The losing team then will be eliminated, and their hopes and dreams of trying to get to Williamport will be, unfortunately, coming to an end.
The way both teams are playing today, nobody wants to go home. Nobody. I can tell you what, though, when they left the dorms this morning, the beds were messy. They were not made. They're coming back. That's the thought process. No bags are packed. They want to play.
Smith will try to get out of this inning quick. One strike away, facing Marshall.
DC's done a really good job at the plate today. They are up battling, all out. Good try outside corner. Ball was outside. Good try.
Now the 2-2 pitch by Smith. Swung on and missed. Marshall goes down by way of K. A 9-pitch inning for Foster Smith. At the end of three, Maryland leads DC 8-5.
Ladies and gentlemen, concession stand is open behind the first base grandstand. Volunteers work tirelessly to keep your hunger and thirst in check. Visit the stand now for your selection of hot and cold food, ice cold beverages, and the best in ball game snacks. Thank you for your support of Little League Baseball.
Yeah.
John Brick, the Dave Belisle, back with you in Bristol. We have seen great offense today. Now we're seeing some great plays in the outfield.
Some incredible plays in the outfield. We could have had back-to-back doubles here. Easily had back-to-back doubles. But two nice plays out there. Lucas Long making a nice grab in center field. And then we saw the effort out there by Salido. Oh, all out. Even we didn't even show the package where he made that all-out effort. Could have been three that inning. Three. Good defense.
Maryland has backed up that good defense with solid offense. Two runs in the first, two runs in the second, four more in the third. They lead 8-5 as we begin this fourth inning. Alex Navarro at the dish, the cleanup hitter here for Berlin, Maryland. That one gets into center field for a leadoff base hit for Navarro.
Good looking hitter, Navarro, keeping those hands in right there, driving it right up the middle. Carmichael makes a good pitch, gets it in on him. Nice stroke, keep his hands in, drive through the middle. Feeling good. Ready to run. To be run four.
So Riley Callaway will be the pitch runner. The special pitch runner here for Maryland, up 8-5.
Running for Navarro.
Special runner that can be used two times per game. First pitch swinging opposite way, just foul off the bat of Lucas Loring, who we saw make that great play in center field.
McKinley making a nice stop on a fly on a foul ball, but good job, good effort right there. Oh yeah, we saw that great catch, and he's had a good day at the plate also.
Trying to go for second on the steal, Loring, that one goes into center field, so he advances, does Callaway all the way to third. And the runner in scoring position once again for Maryland, up by three.
This is a straight steal right here. Speed. Great speed. Now I know why he pinch ran. He can fly. Callaway actually is flying down there.
Hey, that's turn your head. Difficult. He's already at third.
That's one of the most difficult things in Little League is to get a stolen base at this level, the tournament level.
Loring falls behind in the count 1-2.
Carmichael has done his job. He's come in, he's throwing strikes. This Maryland team is on fire right now and feeling it.
Looking to get another run across, up by three. Check swing, they appeal down to first, did not go.
Big inning for DC to try to stem the tide here. Can't give up a big spot right here.
Loring cut out and missed, and he goes down by way of the K, the first out of this fourth inning.
Big out. Huge out. Difficult. Nobody out, man on third. To leave that runner at third base. Difficult task. But a good stop for Mr. Carmichael's.
So a strikeout, and now Case Tillman was hit by a pitch the first time up. Here with one out.
Getting hot behind that plate. Heston doing a nice job blocking it. Keeping it in front of him. Big run at third base.
Favorite movie, Fast and Furious 7. Have you seen the first six?
Nice pitch. The first six movies. Have you seen Rocky, all of them?
I have. You know which one my favorite is?
Don't say later ones.
Yeah.
Come on.
4 and 5.
Good.
Tommy Gunn, come on, classic. That one right in front of Hairston makes the play. Nice pitch off of Carmichael. They're two away.
Nice catch. One of the more difficult plays for a catcher. But you don't have.
And trying to go home because no one's covering. And a great heads-up play by Riley Callaway. No one was covering home, so he darted right from third, got home, and put a run across.
And his legs, Callaway's got the legs. He steals second, goes to third on a wild throw, and he comes home in between the pitcher and the catcher. And look at this, just a little transfer. Now he takes a moment to pick up his hat, and here he's gonna come. Look at this, wait a minute here. I'm going.
That's incredible.
That is quickness, man. That is quick.
Turn your head, he already scored.
That's a big run. That's a huge momentum turner right there. Yeah, Carmichael's done a great job, and he still has done a great job. Yeah, the man up third, nobody out, gets those two big hitters.
Give credit to Callaway. Smart play for a young man of that age to have the wherewithal to go right to home with no one covering the plate.
opposite way, set to right, having to play in, unfortunately not making the play, is Marshall, rounding first into second with a two-out double is Adam Gardner.
Gardner does a nice job here driving the ball the other way. Marshall had a beat on it, just misplayed it a little, but at least he had the presence of mind. Hit your cutoff, don't give him an extra base. But a nice job. Put the balls in play. Get some more speed in the base paths. Are you satisfied yet? Not yet.
So now Callaway, who just pinch ran, the special pinch runner before, now gets a plate appearance in this fourth inning. Can you imagine being able to steal home and potentially getting another run across on a base hit? I don't think it's ever happened before.
Yeah. And Carmack is saying, didn't this guy just score? Do I have to deal with this guy again?
I looked down, I said, 48. I said, I just thought we saw 48 come across. Maybe I'm getting old. Huh. I don't agree with
Maybe
that.
Maybe I get the wrong number.
Don't agree with that. He's ahead in the count 2-0 to Carmichael.
Nice battle back by Colin. He's done a nice job. He really has. He's been unfortunate with some of the plays, but keep it going, son. You're in the game. 9-5. Your batters are going to get another chance three more times. Keep it close.
Ooh! Hits him in the head. Fortunately, able to stand right up. But a scary situation. Callaway's going to take his base.
Looks like he's okay, but I think they will come out and check him regardless. It's just mandatory.
I mean, that pitch got away from Carmichael, who went right over
right
to
over.
Make sure that Callaway was okay.
Good stuff. Didn't mean it. Got away from him. He's been pitching great. Oh, boy. You know how close that is, John? Oh.
Almost sounded like the contact, the ball hit the bat. That's how hard it hit the helmet.
Yep.
Off the pitch of Carmichael. But again, the great sportsmanship. Carmichael went right over afterward to Callaway, shaking his hand, making sure that he was okay.
Thank God for this incredible safe equipment these young boys are wearing today.
So now Coach Barnes is going to go and make another pitching change. The new pitcher is going to be Rocco Gilbert, who started at shortstop. We'll set everything straight. 9-5, Maryland with the lead, looking to add to it.
Jr. moves to shortstop, and into pitch is number 33, Rocco Gilbert.
Back in Bristol, Connecticut, 9-5 Maryland, the lead on DC here in the top of the fourth inning. A new pitcher, Rocco Gilbert. Meanwhile, we've seen professional athletes that have made it from Little League all the way up to the pros. How about some famous actors as well who have done that? We'll get to that in just a moment. So stolen bases now for Berlin, Maryland. They advance second and third with two outs in the fourth.
Guess who stole the base? Callaway flying.
A Ball gets away, sliding in, and scoring is Adam Gardner, and makes it a 10-5 lead for Maryland. So Briggs Buckner is the new hitter for Berlin. A 10-5 lead, 1-1, the count with two outs. That one in there for a called strike. So Maryland, again, consistently here, Dave, has been able to put runs on the board, two at least in every inning in this game.
And they're wearing out the pitching at the same time.
That one swung on and missed. That ends the inning, but two more runs come across. Maryland extends their lead on DC 10-5 midway through the fourth.
Day trading is a tradition at the Eastern Regional Tournament and at the Little League Baseball World Series in Williamsport, Pennsylvania. Official Little League pins are available for purchase at the Little League gift shop located near the pavilion. Also, you can try your luck in our daily pin raffles.
Well, we teased this earlier. We've seen athletes make it from Little League all the way to the pros. How about some famous actors as well? Brad Pitt, Zac Efron, why not? Oh, Tom Selleck, your boy Tom Selleck.
Oh my God, my boy.
Jason Aldean as well, Entertainer of the Year last year. Luke Bryan, just some of the big names that have played on the diamond in Little League Baseball. And it just shows how much success, how much fun everyone has all the way through all different age groups.
Absolutely. You mentioned Tom Selleck. You know, my aunt, my God bless her, used to say when I grew a mustache, I looked like Tom Selleck. And then my brother John brought out a picture of Groucho Marx. He said, no, auntie, he looks more like this.
I would have to disagree with your auntie on Tom Selleck looking like you. I'm sorry.
Hey,
I don't buy it.
You dream. You
I
know?
Don't buy it. If we were in the heat, maybe I'd buy it. So bottom of the fourth inning, D.C. down by five runs, looking to orchestrate a rally. As Joshua Young leads it off here in the bottom of the fourth.
How about the job that Foster Smith has done coming off the bench and giving him innings? And look, they're keeping at that five spot that was put up in the first inning. It's still there.
Young, slow roller to Smith. Quick throw to first. And able to get the first out of this bottom of the fourth.
Outstanding play by Foster right there. Doesn't rush to the ball. Sets himself. Makes a strong throw. What a nice play right there. He jumps off the mound. He gets to it, sets himself, picks it up. Perfect strike.
Langston Speed with one out, first pitch swinging. Some of these great names. I think two of them are here today. Cannon Cropper for Berlin, Maryland, and Langston Speed. I mean, that's a great name.
Great name.
Squares up to bunt. I mean, that's a situation where if your last name is Speed, you have to be fast.
Exactly. Thank God I wasn't given that name.
That one hits him in the back. So with one out, Smith hits speed. He gets on the base path. And that's what DC needs right now. They need base runners.
They sure do. And one of the guys, one of the kids that's had a great game is this young boy coming up to the plate.
Gilbert Scott, who's been able to beat out two infield hits to get on base.
He goes up there hacking. I love it.
Good stance, too.
I love it.
What do you preach for players at this age to try to develop?
You know what? They got to find, they got to find their comfort zone. You know, just good balance is the key.
Again, fouls it away.
And staying back. But this is, I love to watch this young boy hit.
Jabril Scott, two singles in this game, facing an 0-2 count. Sends this one to left, trying to make a diving attempt at it, was Hopgood. Foul territory, so we'll reset at 0-2.
Good effort out there. Kids going all out today.
I love the shades, though. That's what's really standing out to me, are some of these sunglasses. I mean, these kids look like professional ball players with those glasses.
And they need them today, but they do look sharp.
The weather in the 90s today, if Gad in the humidity, Scott taking 1-2.
When you're a good hitter like Scott, you get the benefit of a doubt right there. It was a close pitch, but he's been aggressive, and the umpire knowing we've got a good hitter up there.
Scott again fouls it away. I think that hit your car. Maybe a couple. 1-2 pitch with speed on first. Scott. Ground ball in the center field. What an at bat by Jabril Scott. He's got his third hit of the day.
What a smooth hitter he is. Driving that ball up the middle. Smoking it up the middle right there. Nice job of hitting. Look at the effort by Gardner, too. Good try. Hey, we got a good shot here, DC. Get your guy up.
Tony Hairston taking the first pitch ball with one out. Down by five is DC, losing their opening game to Staten Island, New York, back on Sunday in the opening round of this regional tournament.
Gotta love these parents and grandparents, and that's what we have this morning. That's, you know, it's a hot morning. We've got two teams coming from a long distance and cheering them on are their parents and grandparents and relatives and a few friends, and God bless them for being here and supporting. It's a hot day.
One of two elimination games in the Mid-Atlantic region today. Hairston to second. Easy play at first for Gardner as both runners advance, so second and third with two outs for DC.
Right decision by Gardner. You got a speedy Scott going down to second base. It would have been a difficult play. It probably could have done it. He's so smooth at second, but he took the out. And you need him at this point here. You've got a lead, 10-5. Now you get two outs. You get one more and get back in the dugout.
Juwan Taylor, who began this game on the mound, here with two outs, runners in second and third.
Foster still doing a great job keeping his infielders alive, throwing strikes, painting corners. Big at bat for Taylor.
And a great story about this Mamie Johnson Little League team out of D.C., the first predominantly African-American team to advance to the Mid-Atlantic Regional Tournament. Named after Mamie Johnson, the first female pitcher in the Negro League.
That's something, isn't it? Right there. Isn't that something?
It's incredible. It has been just a remarkable story for these young players. 3-0, and Taylor sends one to shallow
nice
right.
Job.
That's going to fall in for a base hit. Speed comes in from third to score. It's a 10-6 lead for Maryland, still with runners at the corners for D.C.
Nice job. Don't want anything. A nice job staying with it. A little bit off the end of the bat, but does his job and gets a big ribby at the right time. Keep the momentum going. Beautiful piece of hitting. Clutch hit.
That brings up Carmichael. First pitch swinging. That one got out of the park in a hurry.
They're going for it. DC is aggressive, and they want to get right back in this game. They're down by four. Get speed in the base paths. Not literally speed, but they do have speed on the base path. Good job by Carmichael.
DC's first run since they put up a five-run first inning in this game.
Ian Foster. What a job he's done getting into the later portion of his pitch count.
Carmichael right back to Smith. Play to first. That ends the inning. One run scores for DC. They trail 10-6 at the end of four here in Bristol.
Your attention, please. Your safety is our primary concern to us while you enjoy the game action here at Breed Field. High heat and humidity are in the forecast for today, so be sure to drink plenty of fluids.
In the dancing mood this afternoon in Bristol, Connecticut. A beautiful day, and even the manager of Berlin, Maryland there, Cameron McDonough, showing off the dance moves. All smiles for that man. 10-6 Maryland with the lead on DC. One of two elimination games today here at the Giamatti Center. Look at those dance moves. Belial, he puts you to shame, man.
Oh my God. Holy Moses.
Puts you to shame.
I love it. I love it.
Oh my goodness.
My God.
It's great to see the environment here.
It really is. It really, really is.
All smiles everywhere. And again, one of two elimination games today. Winner moves on, continues on the journey to try to get to Williamsport. If not, their season will come to an end. Winner of this game will play the winner of Delaware and Pennsylvania coming up on Thursday at 7 p.m. Eastern. So Rocco Gilbert to start things off on the mound in the top of the fifth.
And Rocco needs to put up a goose egg here. His team's within reach. Big inning for him.
Misses outside. As Cannon Cropper, favorite player Manny Machado, leading off this game. Started on the mound, had some difficulties in the first where DC put up five runs. Taking all the way for a called strike.
Quite an entertaining game between the music, the dancing, the defense, the hitting.
We've had a little bit of everything.
Everything today.
1-2 pitch.
Nice try right there. Maryland will continue to put the pressure on, though. They're a great hitting team. Gonna have to play some defense, boys.
That one misses high. Nice job by Crawford to battle his way back to a full count.
Big pitch right here. Don't want to give any freebies. Just make him think of play.
A leadoff walk surrendered by Rocco Gilbert. Begin the fifth.
Unfortunately, it brings up Mr. Wade again. Mr. Kinnear, so he's got a lot of work ahead of him, but he can do it. Just make the right pitches.
Single today along with a walk, three RBIs for Stephen Wade. Keep in mind that this offense for Maryland has put up at least two runs in every inning of this game. It's already got a stash going. Look at that. You know how long it would take me to grow a beard? Like 9 months. Wade, first pitch swinging. Out of play.
These foul balls, there's just not a lot of room over here in these foul balls.
Wade, ground ball that gets through for a base hit, so the first two runners in this fifth inning reaching for Berlin, Maryland, threatening once again with Owen McNair coming to the plate.
Wade stays hot. He's been finding holes all day.
Speaking of Kinnear, this is what he was able to do in the first inning with a runner on. I always love to say it still hasn't landed. A two-run shot in the first, part of a three home run performance he has had in this tournament so far has Owen Kinnear.
He can put more distance here between him and his opponent.
Checks his swing for a called strike.
Gilbert will have to continue to throw the off-speed stuff and keep it down. The game is over 2 hours old. John, these players are getting hot. You gotta stay constant. Your concentration's gotta stay there. It's tough though. That's why it's so important for Gilbert to throw strikes, keep his team in the game.
Get what you want, you take it. Get what you want, you take it. 1-1 pitch from Gilbert. Kinnear lost one up. Easy play on a communication with Scott making the play at center field.
Big out right there.
That is the first out of this fifth inning. An absolutely crucial out to get with the power of Kinnear.
That's what Gilbert's got to do. Continue to keep the ball in on the hands and the outside corners. Let your fielders play. There's a nice catch out there by Scott.
Alex Navarro, cash money they call. The chance to add to this lead. 10-6 Maryland with the lead.
Again, delay steal.
And going into third, beating the throw. As Cropper with the heads up play. And that sets up runners at first and third.
Again, the transfer back from Houston. Back to the pitcher, the Gilbert. Just a great job right there. Good piece of running. Cropper just anticipating, lurking, waiting, see what's gonna happen, and took off.
A one pitch to Navarro. And the steal, Hairston fakes the throw down to second. So Wade now in the scoring position.
Well, part of this winning formula for Maryland, as we see today, is definitely speed. Absolute speed in the base paths. And it's a difference maker in this game.
In there for a called strike. As Navarro falls behind 1-2. Navarro, foul tipped it.
Hey, Alex, drop third and play.
And DC's going to bring the infield in on the left side. Might bring him in all the way around. They're going to keep it on the right side, deep. But with the speed of Maryland, it's going to be very difficult to make a play. No need to. What a pitch.
Navarro caught looking on strike three, so there is two away after the punch out by Gilbert.
And boy, did he need that. Big pitch at a big moment. Great job by Gilbert.
Now batting for Maryland.
Now you can move the infield back. And now he has another difficult hitter.
A single and a double for Loring halfway through the cycle.
Now we see Hairston and Gilbert really starting to communicate in their transfers of balls back and forth of what's happened so far. Cannot let that happen again. I thought the effort by Gilbert right here, John. He is working and he's giving everything he has. That's what these boys are doing. He's giving his team a chance. He's facing a difficult part of the order. And he's fighting.
This is low and falls behind in the count 2-1. Chance for Maryland threatening with two on. Cropper at third, Wade at second. And that one swung on and missed. Gilbert is one strike away here, Dave, from getting out of this jam.
Man, he's got that off-speed curve working to perfection right now. He's got them lunging. Very deceiving as he's throwing it. He hides it well. He needs another one.
Ground ball, that gets through for a base hit. RBI single will score Cropper. In the score is Wade. And advancing on to second is Loring, who is having an incredible day. Now three hits and is added to the lead for Maryland. Now 12-6, the advantage on DC.
Well, Loring got a fastball that he loves right over the middle of the plate and delivers right through the shortstop hole right there. Big hit, big moment. He's had a day to remember. Good job, son.
Berlin, Maryland has scored again, another two runs.
You look at that scoreboard, John, 2-2, 4-2, 2. They don't stop.
Brings up Case Tillman.
Nice stop by Harrison.
Nine hits, that has equaled 12 runs here for Maryland in this elimination game. Winner will play the winner of Pennsylvania and Delaware coming up Thursday at 7 Eastern. Called strike. Even up the count at 1-1.
Another good pitch by Gilbert. Seems like every time there's an opportunity to get a pitch that's over the plate, Maryland finds it and hits it. I mean, Gilbert's pitched extremely well.
Another foul ball. Nice play at third by Coach McDonough.
I really do like Gilbert, though. Has not lost his composure. And why should he? I mean, he's pitched really well. That's so important for your teammates.
In the dirt, even up the count at 2-2. And D.C. fell to New York 10-2 in the opening round on Sunday. Here they are trailing by six First appearance for this DC program that was established in 2015. Keith Barnes, who has been one of the architects in helping develop this team, had help from Orioles outfielder Adam Jones, who donated close to $9,000 for the bus transportation for these players to make the trip up to Bristol. As Rocco Gilbert trying to get out of the jam, payoff pitch. Too high, and Case Tillman draws a two-out walk.
DC, you know, adding to that, John, DC has done a wonderful job here, coming here and playing with pride. Now, if you were just showing up at the park right now, you didn't know which team was which, you take a look at the way I'm looking at DC, you know, the heads are high, you know, they're battling. Couldn't tell if they were on the wrong end of the stick here. And that's because of this young boy, Gilbert, and the way that they're playing with pride.
Adam Gardner with a chance to add to it, two on with two outs, taking all the way on that first pitch. A single, a double. What I appreciate, favorite band, Guns N' Roses. Guns N' Roses.
Heavy metal, man. This kid carries heavy metal. He's a good hitter.
Wow.
How about that?
And not in this lifetime tour, I'm being told that they're doing this summer. You gonna go?
Yeah, in between Little League games.
So 3-0, Gilbert has fallen behind. Here to Adam Gardner with two outs and a 12-6 lead for Maryland.
Nice pitch.
Taking all the way. Gilbert gets the strike call.
Stay with it, son. You're doing marvelous. Doing marvelous.
Gardner gets under it.
Tough play.
Tough play for the second baseman. Falls in for a base hit. One run will score. Second run comes across, and he's
nice
out
throw.
At the plate. What a throw from the outfield. Hairston applied the tag, and Tillman called out at the plate, but another run comes across. Three runs in total. It's 13-6. Maryland in front of DC, but another web gem off the bat of Gardner. Falls in for a base hit, and then what a throw by Scott to get the runner Tillman out at home. Another great web gem we've seen.
They offer a wide variety of products to choose from and are eager to show you their best shots. Just keep in mind, the photos are not available online.
All smiles today at the Giamatti Center. A beautiful day here in Bristol, Connecticut, as Adam Gardner will be the new pitcher for Berlin. And a 13-6 lead going up against this lineup with Carmichael to lead things off for DC.
Adam Gardner playing second base will be number 50, Foster Smith, and catching once again number 37, Ryder Swanson.
Ryder Swanson now the new catcher once again, back behind the plate. Excuse me, it's Solomon McKinney who will be making the start at the plate going up against Gardner to begin this fifth, the bottom half.
And McKinney's had a good tournament too. He's made some nice first base, he's gotten on base.
Had that key two-run double that initially gave DC
yes,
the advantage.
Mm-hmm.
They would add five runs in that first inning.
Takes a lot of hacks up there. Does not get cheated. Kind of doing a good job, throwing the strikes, pounding the zone.
1-2 pitch coming from Gardner.
McKinney's a confident hitter too. Gets right back in there. Bring it, baby. Come on.
McKinney opposite way. Base hit. Nice piece of hitting by Solomon McKinney to get the leadoff man on here for D.C.
You can just tell by the body language. This boy can play the game.
Up in the
and he wants to hit.
Columbia is number 33, Rocco Gilbert.
He is ready. What a nice piece of hitting right there.
The pitcher Rocco Gilbert steps in. And going for second is McKinney. And he is out trying to attempt stealing second. Swanson with a great throw.
Must have been some miscommunication there. It happens, you know, you're trailing by six runs. Must have got the wrong sign.
And Gilbert to left, making the play is Hopgood for the second out.
Nice job by Hopgood. Get out there. Don't time it. Get under it. Make the play. Smile, son. Made a nice play.
Steven Showalter. Favorite athlete, Max Scherzer. First pitch swinging.
And Gardner, just like Smith before him, has done a wonderful job of keeping that score.
Showalter to first, easy play for the first baseman Navarro. And the inning comes to an end. End of five, Maryland, 13-6. Good news, we still have another game. Oh, you have three. Yeah, never mind. I don't feel as bad. Yeah, okay, cool. Yes, yep, 100%.
Yeah. Why are we showing the second baseman? I think there was one of your graphics there had the second baseman making an error. Why are we showing that? Well, it was a play, right?
Yeah, it was the second highlight that they showed. You can't take that out, can you? Okay.
Okay.
Look at our game summary here today. Berlin, Maryland has put up at least two runs in every inning to this point. Owen Kinnear with a home run in the first. That would be his third of this tournament. Meanwhile, Stephen Wade, 2-for-2. Jabril Scott, though, a positive note for D.C., 3-for-3. However, the team that loses this game will be eliminated on the road to Williamsport. But still, Maryland and D.C. have been fighting back and forth this entire game, Coach.
It really has been a back and forth affair and a lot of fight out there from both teams. Nobody wants to go home. They're showing resiliency. There's no quitting either one of these teams' games. I've been very proud to be standing here broadcasting this game to see boys working hard for each other and fighting to stay alive. I like it.
Well, the mentality does change when you have an elimination game of this magnitude between these two teams. D.C. making it for the first time ever. The Mamie Johnson Little League team, located just 13 miles outside of D.C. As for Berlin, Maryland, trying to get back to the Little League World Series for just the second time ever in their program history.
And they certainly got the team to do it. They played very well today. Very well. They got the bats going. They got some outstanding pitching from Foster Smith. And Adam Gardner done a great job. So they played really well today.
Well, the nickname Dash fits well for Riley Callaway. We saw his speed on the base path. A pop fly that was caught by Hairston. And heads up play. Home plate was open, and my man dashed, went right to home plate to score.
Absolutely. You know, we've seen a couple guys that have come off the bench. You know, one of them, this Riley Callaway, has come off the bench, and his speed has made a huge difference in this game. Foster Smith has come off the bench, and he's done a wonderful job pitching. This is a complete team from Maryland.
Inside, Callaway has to get away from that pitch. Misses high as Gilbert. Falls behind the count 3-1. Again, the winner of this game is going to move on and face off Thursday night at 7 Eastern against the winner of Delaware and Pennsylvania. And that one cut on and missed, and it's a full count to Callaway.
A great day. Little League Baseball throughout the whole nation going on today, tomorrow, Friday, Saturday. And then the big tournament coming up. It's a great time of the year.
Missing high, and Callaway reaches with a leadoff walk. Want to play Little League in your local community? Visit playlittleleague.org and enter your address to find a Little League program near you. Erland, Maryland making the long trek up to Bristol, up by 7 runs. As Gavin Salido, who we have seen in right field, makes some great web gems today. Derek Carr's favorite athlete. And that one brushed and seemed to be the uniform of Salido. And so the first two runners have reached for Maryland in the sixth inning.
Not easy right here for Gilbert. Stay composed, son. You've done a wonderful job. Deep breath. You can do it.
Proper squares to bunt. Looking to advance the runners. And now a stolen base to third. And allows Salido to get to second. Just like that, runners are in scoring position for Maryland here, Dave, with nobody out.
Again, Callaway leading the way, taking that extra base. And Salido, smart base runner, see the front runner running. He take advantage. And now he's on second. And let's give a shout out to Hairston back there in this heat. He's done a wonderful job.
You add in the humidity, it's over 90 degrees today. Green Field. That one in there for a strike, makes it a 2-1 count. I was watching a couple of weeks ago, Dave, when we had what we like to call rain delayed theater on ESPN for the Orioles and Red Sox, and they were speaking to the umpires. One of the umpires, Fielding Colbreth, one time lost 14 pounds wearing all that pads in Arlington, Texas.
No way.
A base hit that brings home another run, advancing to second.
How about the throw out there? Wow. What a gun he has. Scott again.
But can you imagine 14 pounds you lose wearing all the gear?
Now who we got out there? What a throw this was. Look at this. Look at this. This is McKinney. That's a perfect strike.
Well, the run that scores makes it a 14-6 lead for Maryland, still with nobody out.
Imagine him coming home to his wife. Are you my husband? Right?
It's a great way to lose weight, though.
Oh, yeah. You look good, honey.
Thanks. I just went to the gym for 3 hours. You look good, honey. Stephen Wade skies this one up. Gilbert trying to make a play on it.
Oh! Did he get it?
Dives out and makes an unbelievable catch. Full extension of the body.
Oh, DC, be proud, boy. You keep playing. There's no time limit, boys, to make great plays like this. Look at this young boy. He's staying with it. He's staying with it. Oh, what a great play. Another web gem. We've seen him today, John. We've been full packed with web gems, and what a nice play.
Owen Kinnear here with two on, a chance to get this lead to double digits. Even if they do get to the 10-run rule, Maryland will still have to play the bottom half of the sixth inning.
And Maryland wants to play.
Kinnear, just out of the way was coach Cameron McDonough. Takes a big, big sigh of relief after that one.
I'm telling you, man.
Ole, nice bullfighting mentality right there.
Tied for the tallest player in this regional tournament, along with his teammate Stephen Wade at 5'10". Battling with a 2-1 count. Kinnear sends one to left center field. He's got his second home run of the game. This one, a 3-run shot. He's now got 5 RBIs in this game, and Maryland has broken it open in the sixth.
This is his personal launching pad. That's what he's making here in Bristol. This young boy has got power extraordinaire, and there goes another one. He just keeps it back and strides into that ball and sends it a long way.
His fourth home run in this regional tournament, all smiles for Owen Kinnear. 2 home runs in this game, now 17 runs total for Maryland.
And Gilbert still poised, still keeping his composure. Love it.
That was nearly the exact same place he hit his first inning home run.
He's a presence, he's a player. And they're going to be a team to reckon with as we go forward, and they are going to go forward.
Unless Washington, D.C. can have some kind of rally, unlike any other we would see in the bottom of this inning.
Well, they'll put up a fight, that's for sure.
2 home runs for Owen Kinnear, 4 in this tournament.
Nice pitch.
Navarro taking
nice
for the strike 3. And that is the third strikeout for Rocco Gilbert this afternoon with 2 outs.
One thing I'd like to mention, John, is that the coach or the manager, Cameron McDonough, he doesn't have a kid in the game. You know, he's here teaching, coaching, giving his time. For the love of the game and for the love of the community, and good job, coach. Very impressed.
Lucas Loring now the batter with 2 outs in a 17-6 game. Nearly 2.5 hours we have played this game today, Dave.
coming up. We got some great games coming. See if we can finish here. Get back in that dugout.
This one sent into the gap in left center. That's going to reach all the way to the wall. Loring pulls into second with a stand-up double here with two outs. And that will be his fourth hit today for Lucas Loring.
What a game. What a game, Lucas. What a stroke. The momentum that Maryland is producing over here is going to make everybody else in this tournament take notice. Berlin is real.
Tillman now the batter with two outs. Runner at second. Ball gets away from Hairston, advancing to third is Loring now on the wild pitch. So here's an interesting question to pose to you, Coach.
Yep.
You played in elimination games before. When you put up 17 runs
yep.
in a game like this, what does that do for your confidence level for you and the coaches and the players?
It's a tremendous feeling. Your team has found itself at the right time. At the right time. Now you're believing again. It's not like you ever doubted yourself, but there was always some questions. That, oh, you know, that elimination game gets you a little scared. It's going to end. And a game like this brings a new beginning. It's a new oomph to your play. So.
Two-one pitch coming from Rocco Gilbert. Cut on and missed by Tillman. Hairston trying to find the ball right in front of him. Loring was halfway down the base path third.
And each one of these boys that are coming up to the plate, you're saying, oh, when's it going to end? You know what? They've worked hard. They want their at-bats. They want to get hits. And this is important for Maryland, every individual player from Maryland. They want to get up there. They want to hit. They want to play. And that's what they're showing. They're not scoreboard watching. They're going up there like they've been taught. And they've worked at it. So
the Maryland offense producing 17 runs on 13 hits with five extra base hits. Kinnaird with two home runs. And another base hit by Tillman. That'll bring home Loring. It's now an 18-6 lead for Maryland.
Nice hit there by Case. He's feeling good too.
Coming to the plate for Maryland is number.
Nice to see everyone getting involved, especially as a coach. He's been, you know, nothing better than having a lineup that can produce top to bottom and everybody contributing.
And Keith Barnes out of the dugout is going to make a pitching change.
Hey, good job, man. Way to fight. Good job. Yo. We just got to keep fighting, okay? We just got to keep fighting. Let's go ahead and get out this inning and try to put some runs up. Go to first.
Nice job, son.
So Maryland with an 18-6 lead. We saw a year ago the big leagues being played at Williamsport. What an atmosphere it was, Dave, just a year ago.
We knew the Little Leaguers would be excited to meet the Big Leaguers and their heroes, because this is something they will never forget.
All 16 teams have gathered here to see a Big League game. And Bell breaks one. First pitch gone. A diving catch.
Classic. It was great last year. Pirates and the Cardinals coming up August 19th at 7 p.m. Eastern. It's going to be the Mets and the Phillies from Williamsport. For those, Coach, who have not been a part of Williamsport or have not been able to see a game in person, give us a sense of what that atmosphere that environment is like.
It's an incredible environment. Now that they've added the major leagues to that environment, it just brings an extra special meaning. I mean, yesterday, I mean, last year, John, I know you watched it too. I thought it was tremendous. The interaction between the major leaguers and those young ball players, especially when the young ball players were on the field playing while the major leaguers were watching and interacting with the teams that were just watching the game with them. Just the appreciation from the major leaguers for those young kids. It's a tremendous feeling. I'm sure the ball players this year, the Mets, the Phillies, they're excited to go too.
And speaking of your trips to Williamsport, 2011, 2014. Of course, everyone remembers 2014 for that iconic, epic speech that you gave to your players afterwards. But it certainly is a moment to remember for not only the players, but the coaches, the parents, the grandparents, everyone involved.
Well, you know, in that speech it said friends forever. And that involves quite a number of people. It's my players first and foremost. It's the parents that I met, the grandparents. But it's also Little League Baseball. Friends forever. It's those volunteers. It's the people that you meet that gave you that experience. And when you say something like friends forever, it's about Little League Baseball and what they gave me the opportunity and my players the opportunity to have a wonderful experience. It's a great game.
Jabril Scott, the new pitcher, falling behind the count 2-1 to Adam Gardner. Scott, who in fact had the great throw from center field last inning. And that one in there for a called strike, 2-2.
Yeah, that was a beautiful throw. Like I said before, it was like he was playing quarterback. He was just looking at that catcher and he threw a strike. Looks pretty good on the mound, too. Nice pitch.
That one in there for a called third strike. Gardner goes down by strikeout, 18-6. Maryland, three outs away from keeping their season alive.
Bristol, Connecticut, the site of this elimination game as DC down to their final three outs as we move to the bottom of the sixth inning, 18-6. Maryland with the lead. It has been an incredible journey for the boys from Mamie Johnson Little League. Started off with the district play all the way to states winning, a program that started back in 2015, and now they are here in Bristol, the first predominantly African-American team to advance to the Mid-Atlantic Regional. Fans joining up, the elevation, the energy level as high as it could be. And for a young team that's gotten support not only by the community but by professional athletes, Adam Jones, the Orioles outfielder, contributing over $8,000 after a Twitter message was seen via a Washington reporter. He contributed close to $9,000 to help with the bus transportation to bring these boys up to Bristol. And they have put together a great showing in their two games here in this Mid-Atlantic Regional Tournament.
And they should be proud because they have put on quite a performance over here. But along the way, they're going to have memories. They're going to last forever. But their coach has said it so many times with his presence out there on the mound. Fight. That's what this team has come. They've come this far because of the fight that they have. And they're going to battle right to the very end.
And they even made a trip to the headquarters. ESPN back on Monday, getting a chance to be on the NFL live set. And an experience unlike any other for these players. True pioneers, true trailblazers for a program that started in 2015. And that is one of the great advantages of having this tournament here in Bristol, is that ESPN is just a quick 5-minute drive down the road. And you've been there before.
Yes, I have.
With Cumberland.
Yes, I have been there before. And ESPN does such a great job. And it's nice to go there and see how it works and see how it's what makes it tick and give the kids an opportunity to, you know, rub their elbows with people like you, John, and see how it's done, because it's not easy.
I remember the first time I met you in the hallways at ESPN. You remember what you first said to me?
Hi, John.
Move out of the way, kid. Dave Belisle, John Brickley with you. This is now our fifth game together.
Yes, it has been, and it's been a pleasure, an absolute pleasure. And it's been a pleasure watching this D.C. team. And obviously this Berlin team has been so dominant today.
Dave, I want you to know something, because yes, I think everyone listening can attest to this. You are the most positive person I have ever met in my life.
Well, that's what Little League Baseball has done to me. It's given me a positive outlook.
Mako with the ground ball to second with the first out. I mean, if you think about it, my car could get towed, call you up, and you would say, hey, at least you still have a car. That would be your positive thinking. I give you credit, though. We need more people like that.
Oh, yeah.
And for Mamie Johnson, Little League, as we've mentioned, new territory that they have been able to blaze, the first D.C. team outside of Capital City or Northwest Washington to represent D.C., going all the way back to 98. So there are some true positives to take away from this team.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Glad I got a chance to meet this team.
Jaden Brown steps in with one out. Meanwhile, Berlin, Maryland, going to be on their way to trying to continue their journey for a trip to Williamsport. Brown, the slow roller, back to the pitcher. Gardner with the throw, and the second out is retired.
And Gardner has done a wonderful job. I know we've mentioned the offense. Why not? It's 18 runs, but the pitching of Gardner to come in and give his coach some innings and Smith.
Now batting for the District of Columbia,
he's done a wonderful job.
Jabril Scott, the pitcher.
Jabril Scott, the pitcher. Last chance to take a look at Fairfield in the stands. Fairfield American's going to face off with Zach O'Main. That's coming up next, the elimination game in the New England Regional.
Hey, we get a chance to watch Scott hit again. I love watching this young boy hit.
He's got three hits today.
Oh, boy, he's a pleasure.
Goes opposite way.
Look at that.
The left fielder misplaying it is Callaway. Rounding first into second is Scott. And this D.C. team with still some fight left in them. Scott with the stand-up double with two outs.
What a day, son. Something you'll remember forever. Not the score. You remember this, my friend. Look at this swing. You've done it the whole tournament. He smoked that ball. No chance in left field at all. That was just hammered out there.
That reminds me of a D. Gordon swing.
Oh, yeah. No, I love watching that boy play baseball. I mean, that's a great day. 4-for-4 in an elimination game. You've done everything you could, son.
Tony Hairston, last chance for D.C.
And he's made some great throws.
It's been a good day for Jabril Scott.
Absolutely. And Hairston's done a nice job behind the plate. Done a good tournament.
Hairston taking the entire way. Still ahead in the count, 3-1. Maryland will face off with the winner of Delaware and Pennsylvania that game later tonight. As Hairston lost one.
into left. That's going to fall in for a base hit. Scott rounding third. He's going to score with no problem. Hairston into second with an RBI double.
Make your coach proud. You're showing what made you who you guys are. It's the fight. They keep going. What a nice piece of hitting by Hairston. There you go, Mom. Nice hit right there. Tough pitch. He goes with it. Nice job. You don't want to go home.
Juan Taylor looks to extend the inning. First pitch swinging against Gardner. Game that has gone over 2.5 hours today. Talk about a battle test between two teams. That one nearly hit Taylor. But see, we're used to it, Dave, around here. Red Sox-Yankee games going 4 hours. Taylor swung on and missed, and now DC is down to their final strike.
See if he can finish it here. Not biting.
Two pitch by Gardner. Swung on and missed. That ends it for Berlin, Maryland. They will advance after an 18-7 victory over DC. The boys from Mamie Johnson Little League put up a great fight, but their season unfortunately comes to an end as Maryland will advance. Now they await the winner of Delaware and Pennsylvania. Up next, it's Connecticut and Maine in a elimination game in the New England Regional, followed by Pennsylvania and Delaware. And wrapping up our coverage tonight, New Hampshire and Vermont with all the games available on ESPN+. Once again, our final score, Berlin, Maryland, keeping their hopes alive for a trip to Williamsport. They knock off DC by a final of 18-7. For Dave Belisle and our entire hardworking crew here at ESPN, I'm John Brickley. Thanks for watching the Little League Regionals. Goodbye for now from Bristol, Connecticut. We'll see you coming up with Fairfield American going up against Saco, Maine.